Hi, welcome to the Coffee Chat Show here on Buzzing Pattaya, a show we talk about things that are happening right here, right now, as well as general news, tips, information, advice. Today I'm delighted. Darren, how you doing, my man?
Yeah, good trip. How are you, mate?
2 years ago, mate. 2 years ago.
2 years and a few months, yeah.
Yeah, and you've still got all your hair. How have I gone wrong? What have I done wrong? How does that work? But anyway, we're down here at I-Rovers in the very heart of LK Metro. So if you look on the map now, you'll see exactly where we are. So, mate, 2 years ago, just over 2 years, things weren't as good as they are now, were they?
No, mate, I remember our conversation, and actually a few people came in after they saw that video and said, geez, you okay, mate, you okay? And it was, because it was probably February 2022.
Yeah.
You know, we were, you know, 8 or 9, 10 months into COVID, and you just didn't know when it was going to end.
Oh, it was awful, wasn't it?
You know, and it got to that point when you were thinking, my God, is this going to end?
Yeah.
So, but it was, it did end eventually.
Yeah.
And you know, getting through COVID, as you will well know, is a hell of an achievement. It was a hell of an achievement, and not that many guys in this town made it. So
I must admit, you hit the nail on the head when you said about we got to a stage where we thought, is this ever going to end? Because it just, originally it was going to be like a couple of weeks, then it was like, oh, it's a couple of months.
Yep.
And suddenly it just kept going on and on and on. It was just like, wow, like, what is really happening here? Because it was awful. But the good news is you're here.
Yep.
Things have changed. You've, you know, you've seen it through. You've done well.
Yes.
So in terms of like the last 2 years, now you're back in and you're open again. I mean, how's things picking up?
Well, we knew if we could make it through COVID and we could see so many people dropping off, that we could hit the ground running and we would have been in a really good position. That's what we kept it on the finish line. We just said, if we can make this, if we can keep it going, if we can hold it together, keep putting food on the table for our families, and we should be able to really reap the rewards of being able to get through that period.
Well, I'd definitely say you reap the rewards because, you know, if you don't know about I-Rovers, I'll give you a very brief summary. They're one of the most popular sports bars here in the city. I mean, I don't know how many TVs you got there? 20?
21, mate.
21, there you go. 21 TVs, pool table, golf. What's with the golf?
Yeah, golf's been really important, especially through COVID because, you know, we didn't have any tourists at all. It was nil tourists here. So all that we had to rely on was our expats.
Yeah.
And we had this good, you know, crew of expats who really supported us through. And without them, again, we probably wouldn't have been here. But since then, again, it's one of the things that's hit the ground running. I think back then we were only 1 or 2 days a week. We played 3 days a week now.
Three days.
Monday, Wednesday and Friday. So.
Right.
That's really great.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And what course did you do? Did you cover them all? Or?
Yeah, good question. We're always asked by people, why don't you play the Siams or the Lancashire Banks? And they're fantastic courses, don't get me wrong. But for the expats here, who make up probably 60% of our golfing society, they're on a budget. They're watching their money. So what we're doing is picking the really good value, lower courses.
Yeah.
So pretty much we're looking for 2,000 and under, all in, and that's pretty affordable.
I must admit, I was only talking to some guys in the lounge the other day, and they were talking about golf.
Yep.
And they were saying, and I can't remember the name of the course now, but it was 5,000 something baht.
Ridiculous.
And I'm like, what is that all about? No. $5,000 just to go around. Then you got to pay for the caddies.
Mate, I love me golf, but I'm not paying that much.
No.
I occasionally play those courses, very occasionally when I have groups here, and I'll play with them. And generally, I play pretty bad, so that makes it even worse paying, you know, $5,500 and walking off after playing bad. But that's not the case. It's just that there are great value courses here.
Yeah, there's 28 golf courses here.
For those, all within those an of you, hour of Pattaya.
Yeah, that's the thing. And those of you who love your golf, you may or may not be aware, but there are 28 golf courses in the Chonburi region, which is fantastic. Like Darren said, they're less than an hour away, you know, and there's some stunners. I mean, truthfully, I don't really know much about the golf courses because I spend most of my time in the trees or in the water, so I don't really get to experience the fairways and the greens. But my boy does. What are you playing off now?
I'm back down about 17. But,
17, are you?
But I've been up high and I've been down a little lower, but 17 is about where I should be, I think.
Well, that's 17. I'm the same, but I'm on each hole. that's about my level of ability. But my boy's good. So in terms of the food menu, I mean, obviously you've got a really comprehensive menu. I mean, talk to me about the food that you have on offer.
Look, what I call it is really good, you know, pub food.
Yeah.
Pub grub, if you like. It's consistent, it's good value, and it covers most people's palates, I think, and most people's, and obviously we've got a full Thai range too.
Mm. In terms of breakfast, everyone asks me about breakfast, and I do think, tell us about your breakfast.
Mate, our Bart Buster, you know, 139,
yeah.
It'll fill you for the day, comes with coffee and orange juice, and it's still, I think it's the best value in town, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean,
and the thing is, it's all quality products on the plate. There's nothing cheap there.
Yeah.
You know, you can buy sausages and bacon that's cheaper, but it's not the same quality.
Yeah. So, when we look at like your menu, the comprehensive menu, what's your best-selling dish?
Oh, good question.
I've edged my guess. I'll be honest with you. If you say it, I've got my one. I think it will be.
Our chicken parmesan is pretty popular.
I just mouthed it to the camera. Then you make chicken parmesan.
That's pretty popular. I actually look at the bills every morning, and it's really spread out. It's like three of these, two of those, one of those, and I think, geez, this must be so hard for the kitchen, you know, because they almost get a couple of everything on the menu each day.
Yeah.
You know, so it's not like 40 of these. It's spread out over them, which I think is a good thing, which shows the whole menu is pretty good.
So. Yeah, I must admit, guys, you know, the quality of food is very, very good. The chicken parmesan, the reason I shouted out was because I had it last time I came in, and delicious. They're huge as well. It's really, really big, but yeah, very, very good food. Like I said, breakfast, if you're looking for your breakfast, guys, come down, check out the Bart Buster. It's notorious in the city. Those people that live here will all tell you about the Bart Buster. We all know about it, so come down and have a look at that. It really is good value. And the menu is very comprehensive menu.
Yeah.
Talking about comprehensive,
yep.
Coverage of sports. Now you've got it on point here, and you nailed it down. 21 TVs.
Yeah.
What don't you cover is probably easier to say.
No, I think most sports are covered. I mean, I've said it before, the beautiful thing about I-Rovers is it caters for your sport.
Mm.
In the morning, as you'll see in there now, there's a lot of Americans that come in for their, you know, their NBA, their baseball, their college footy, and of course ice hockey, which is just finished. Through the middle of the day, it caters for the AFL and the NRL.
Yeah.
Rugby union. At night time, you've got the EPL, and at the moment, we've got the Euros on. Long nights. Oh, God.
Everyone's saying Spain. I asked the question over there. People saying England, Spain.
I think it's going to be one of the underdogs. I think someone's going to come through and surprise us.
I actually think that England are going to slip up. I don't think they're going to get through. I think they'll go.
I'd like to see them win, but I just can't.
Yeah, I'm not confident they're going to do that. But we'll see. But everyone that's been watching the channel, everyone's dropping in their comments saying Spain. But we'll see.
I remember Greece won back in the 90s, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And that was a real upset. I think it might be something like this year. But you know,
there you go.
Remember, I said that.
You've heard it here first. Let's see who wins. And while you're watching the show, guys, who do you think is going to win? Mm. My heart says England. My head says probably Spain.
Yeah, you're probably right.
We'll see. Now, you mentioned earlier on about accommodation.
Yeah.
How many rooms you got now?
12.
12 rooms?
Yeah, we've got 12 rooms. And to be honest, we're always about 80% full all year round, even during low season. So, you know, they're a good, they're good value again.
Yeah.
Thanks, mate. They're good value and... They're good pub rooms.
Yeah.
You know, nice, good size, comfortable bed, air conditioning works well, and the water's hot, mate. Not that it really needs to be here.
Yeah. But it's actually nice to have colder water rather than hot water.
It is, absolutely cold.
And in terms of the value of the rooms, what do they start from?
Oh,
$695.
And up to, in high season, $975. Yeah.
And if people are watching now that they want to look at the rooms or book, how will they get in touch with you?
Oh, you can jump on our website. We've got all pictures of the rooms there. But
okay.
Just book through Agoda or Expedia or booking.com where we've got all those partners. So.
All right, well, there you go, guys. So if you do, like I say, I mean, the rooms are nice. A lot of rooms upstairs, the big rooms as well. So if you are looking for somewhere to stay, you are in a very, very central location. And you're right in the heart of everything. So literally, if that's what you want to do, you want to throw yourself in the deep end, well, trust me, you're in the right place here. In terms of how things are going right now, what's the future ahead of you? What have you got plans?
I think, you know, you interviewed me about 8 years ago.
It was a long time ago, wasn't it?
And I said, I probably we want to expand, make another I-Rovers somewhere. But I sort of got off that idea over the years. I just think concentrating on one place and making it the best you can. I just see that people who open other locations, their efforts get diluted through all those. And it generally doesn't work. Generally doesn't. A couple have, but generally it doesn't work. So I just make sure that this place is the best possible place we can make for it. And to give the punters the full sporting experience.
The atmosphere in is brilliant.
Yeah, it's great. That's what everybody says all the time. I mean, we had Origin the other day. Just an amazing atmosphere here. Everybody's, you know, in their colours, but there's good banter.
Yeah.
And everybody just really enjoyed the day. And and the atmosphere, I'm obviously going to say it, I think it's the best in Pattaya.
Oh, no, I mean, I've been in of an evening when we're watching the Premier League.
Yep.
And, I mean, it's bouncing off the walls.
It is. Yeah, it really does.
Yeah, and it's nice because, you know, you kind of like, when you're watching the sport and the atmosphere and the people shouting and cheering, it's really, really good. I really enjoy it. It's a really nice atmosphere. You've done really well with that.
Thanks, mate. Yeah, after the game the other day, there was quite a few customers gave me a message the next morning saying, yeah, fantastic atmosphere, Darren. Great night. Did well. And that's a credit to our staff too, because staff's been with us a long time.
Yeah.
And they know how to handle a crowd like that. They know how to cater for it, and they know how to service the customer.
But I think that's also a credit to you as well, in terms of the fact that, can you not see? Look, this is a BBC production. We're filming. Look. Oh, it's okay. God, dear, look at that. Don't get it on BBC Sport. It's all right. Well, Brian, come and say hello. No, don't run away. Come and say hello. No, I don't want to do that. We shouldn't have said anything then. In terms of sport, do you do UFC in the mornings?
Yeah, UFC Sunday mornings, they're huge. We've got a big one on this Sunday. Always got the championship boxing too, all the title fights, which are always good crowd pullers too.
Yeah.
Just need McGregor to fight again because
He's put it off again, isn't he?
Yeah, he's put it off. There's over the 10 years, almost 10 years I've been here. He's still the best crowd puller. He packs it out every time. So when I heard he was fighting again,
I'm gutted that Tyson and Jake Paul.
I mean that would have been good.
Well, I just wanted to get in the ring and just teach him a lesson. Say, listen, stick to YouTube.
I think
mate. Everybody
was.
Oh, do you know what I mean? Because the trouble is, they just. Oh, I think Mike Tyson's probably the only guy that thinks, to hell with the money, I'm just going to just do what I'm. Because he is prolific. Yeah. And even at his age means nothing. In that area, it means nothing. It might. But sadly, it's not going to happen. It seems, I don't know. But.
They're saying November now, so we'll see.
Yeah, but one of the things that they said was in his clause is that if he knocks him out in the first round, he loses half his purse. That's what, I mean, I don't know how true that is. That's what I was told.
I think it's just
innuendo. Well, yeah, they just said that, someone told me, said, look, if Tyson bangs him out in the first round, which he could quite easily do.
Quite possibly.
Then he loses half his money.
I think the world would be cheering.
Oh, wouldn't it just. Well, it's been a great talking to you, my man.
Yeah, good stuff.
I want to ask you again, because maybe your thoughts have changed. Remember that question I asked you 2 years ago, was we got someone watching the channel now, never ever been to Pattaya before, he's coming here for the very first time, so right, put your bag down there, come and sit next to Dan. What would you give him in terms of words of advice? What would you say, a brand newbie, never been to Pattaya before, what would you tell him?
Oh God, that's good advice.
You've got to remember how you felt now when you first came here.
Yeah, there's a couple of books out there, read them first.
Yeah.
Read them first, that's good education. Just come in and take your time. I mean, I see guys come in here and, it is a great town.
Yeah.
I call it the greatest city in the world. And they come here and they're just so excited and they just, bull at the gate.
Yeah.
And they usually make a few mistakes, as we all have.
Yeah.
Just slow it down, enjoy the place, work it out, take your time, You're going to make mistakes, whoever you are, you're going to make mistakes. Just don't make the same mistake twice.
Well, don't break the three-day rule either.
Absolutely. There's a lot of rules, Trev. There's a lot of rules.
There are, mate. There are out there.
But that's one of them.
But like you said, though, people come out here, myself included, when I very first came here, it was just like, wow, what is this all about?
Yeah.
You just throw yourself in there, and before you know it, you're knee-deep, and you're like, oh, my God, what's going on? So listen to what Darren said there. Just take your time, guys, Every day here is a Saturday, so you don't have to worry. It's not like being back home where you work all week and then you've got the weekend to go and enjoy yourself. every single day is the same as a Saturday. You're exactly. just going to go out there, party hard, enjoy it, and just, you know, step by step, day by day. That's all you got to remember. It's been a pleasure, my man.
Absolutely, Trev.
Thank you, right. Guys, man. If you are into your sports, come down here, check out I-Rovers. It really is. I'll put all the links there, their Facebook and everything. I'll put the link in the description below. Just come down and check them out. Say hello to Darren and the team. They're really, really nice people. Very welcoming. If you love your sport, honestly, the atmosphere in there is just different gravy. You won't experience the atmosphere like that in many other places, to be fair. It's really, really good. All right, that's it from me. That's it from now. Thank you very much, Rodney. As always, please remember, hit the subscribe button and also the bell icon if you'd like to be notified when I bring out a new video. Have a look on our Instagram. Our Instagram's all about nightlife. So if you're looking for the nightlife, like Soy 6, 7, 8, all the girls are there, have a look on Instagram. It's all about that. Likewise, our TikTok is all about daytime stuff, restaurants, bars, hotels. So have a look on there. Jump in our Discord. There's over 20,000 members in there now. We've got a room in there for the iRovers. You can check out the food, the menus, everything. So have a look on there, guys. It's totally free of charge. Just look at the link in the description below. And if you'd like to support the channel, there's a link to our members area. Please join us here on YouTube. Don't go to the website. The website's having a car crash at the moment. So please go to the YouTube. Send me an email, 247pattaya@gmail.com, and then we'll give you access to our members-only Discord. All right, that's it. Thank you very much for watching, guys. And please, as always, wherever you are in the world, stay safe.